look, we're in a position right now where there are, among the many threats we face, which go on all the time, there are two which literally threaten species survival. That's serious. And they're both being escalated. One is the threat of nuclear war, which is quite serious and escalating. And the second is the threat of environmental disaster, which is moving in extremely ominous directions. Take a look at the new Congress, for example. Just about every new congressional representative who came in last November is a climate denier. In fact, Congress has already moved to ban funding for the most mild environmental efforts. And furthermore, unfortunately, many of these people are true believers. So the head of one of the congressional subcommittees, New Republican, explained that global warming can't be a problem because God promised Noah that there wouldn't be another flood. Others are just supported by...
But why do you care about stupid people?
Stupid people. These people have power, and they're carrying out actions. They are carrying out the actions which are defunding possible efforts to do something about these crimes. Furthermore, they're backed by major concentrations of power. The major business lobbies, for example, have announced that they're funding big propaganda campaigns to convince people that this doesn't matter. These are serious issues. Incidentally, if we want to look at stupid people, we find them all over the place. For example, we happen to be right in the middle of a huge financial crisis. People have noticed. And you trace that back. A lot of it comes from a fanatic religious belief in what's called the efficient market hypothesis. That's pure fanaticism. Dominated the economics profession, dominated the Federal Reserve. One consequence was that when an $8 trillion housing bubble developed, totally unrelated to any fundamentals, completely off the 100-year history of housing prices, the profession and the Fed, the central bank, said it's not necessary to pay attention because of efficient markets. I mean, is that very different from God promised Noah?
That's great.